Hello everyone, so maybe some of you saw Nigel Danson's Instagram story last week where he uploaded three raw files, three photos, and he made like a challenge. He wants us to edit these photos. One photo, we will choose one photo of them, edit it, and send it back to him. So I will open the three photos in front of you. I will choose one and I will edit. I haven't done anything to the photo. I will download the photo in front of you. I will make everything to the photo from beginning, from the raw file to the end. And at the end, I will send it back to Nigel Danson and I will show you right now everything. So as you can see right here, I am in Nigel Danson's Instagram profile and I will go to the story and I will open the link and I will choose this photo. So as you can see, this is the first photo and this is the second one, which I like a lot. It's like woodland photo. And this is the last one. I will choose this one and I will edit in front of you. So as you can see right here, this is the raw file and I will start from the beginning. I will just make sure that the photo is 100% leveled. I will take the straighten tool like that. And I will start by enable profile correction and remove chromatic aberration. Let's start with the highlights. I will remove all the clipping. I think something like that is good. After that, I will not open all the shadows. I don't want to make it so flat. I think like that is enough, and I will add a little bit of contrast . Maybe I can give also more exposure, just a little bit. So I will hold the Alt key and I will try to give a little bit for whites, but without making any harsh highlights, and the black just a little bit. The clarity, I will go back something like between 10 and 15, just to give it that soft and morning feeling. The vibrance, I will not overdo anything with the vibrance. Maybe I will just add a little bit. Let me go back a little bit with the highlights. Okay, like that is good. And now with the tone curve, let me try to put it in medium contrast. I know not all of you like to do that, but as I said in my videos, I like to give a little bit of fade to the shadow, something like that, not too much. Maybe brighten up the midtones just a little bit. I will go back and open the shadows more, something like that. So now I will give more saturation to the yellow and to the orange, because these two colors are very important in sunrise or sunset photos. So I will give a little bit to orange and a little bit to the yellow, something like that. So I will not oversaturate them because I still have to work with split toning. I will give to the highlights the same color of the sun, which is something like 50, and let's give 20, the saturation 20, and the color 50, which is the yellow, between the yellow and the orange. And to the shadows, I will give the opposite color, which is the blue. So let's say 230 and I will give 10. So this is without the split toning and with the split toning. The sharpening, I will give, let's say 40, and I will hold the Alt key to make a mask. The noise reduction, I don't think I need any noise reduction. Let's give only 10% noise reduction. So after that, I will give a little bit of postcrop vintage. So now I'll start with the radial filter, and with a brush I will make local adjustment. Let's select the radial filter and we'll make in the center, exactly near the sun, I will give lighten. Let's make it a little bit bigger. I will take back the clarity. And I will also give more saturation. So this is before, after, before, after. So let's try to make the photo warmer a little bit. And give a little bit of exposure. Go back with the highlights to remove all the clipping here. I will crop the photo a little bit. I feel I don't like this rock here. So now I will try to make dodging and burning to some areas of the photo. Right here maybe, and one right here. So what I'm trying to do right now is that I'm increasing the shadow in the shade areas, and I will also select the brush and I will increase the highlights in the areas where the sun is hitting the ground. I will show you right now. So let's take the brush and make dodge or lighten. I want to lighten up the water here. Something like that. Just increase the exposure and the contrast a little bit. The clarity a little bit. It's before, after, just to make it a little bit visible. And I will do the same here. And a little bit here. And now I will select darken and I will increase the shade areas here. So as you can see, I'm just increasing the shade in the shadow areas and I am increasing the lights in the highlights area. So I will make now graduated filter to the sky. What I will do, maybe I will also take off the highlights a little bit, give it more yellow, increase the saturation, increase the clarity a little bit. So this is before, after, before, after. So I'm just taking my time. I don't want to feel that I made any over editing. So now I will export the photo and I will make also a little bit of adjustment in Photoshop. So I will export it like TIFF, sRGB. So now we are in Photoshop. I will duplicate the layer. So now it's called Orton effect, but I will not overdo it. I just give a little bit. I like to give that effect to sunrise or sunset photos, but even to woodland photos, but I don't overdo it. So let's change the opacity of this layer to something like 20. And I will change it to overlay. After that, I will come to filter, blur, Gaussian blur. Here I will give also something like between 15 and 20. So as you can see, this is a before, after. It's not that big effect, but I like always to make it in sunrise or sunset photos or even woodland photos to give a little bit of soft and moody feeling at the morning. So now I will save the photo. I am just making sure if I want to make any last editing, local adjustment or something like that. I'm trying to add a big radial filter here to draw the eye more to the center of the photo. Let's try to make the temperature also a little bit warmer. This is after importing from Photoshop, and here after a little bit of adjustments also in Lightroom. I think I don't want to make anything now. So here is the raw file where we started at the beginning. I don't think I want to add anything. Let's export this photo. The long edge 3000, export. Let's go to the link here in Nigel's Instagram. I will put my email address, my name, and my file. So here I will add my Instagram and submit. So your response has been recorded. So thank you very much again for giving us this chance to edit these three photos and to give us the raw file of these three photos. They are really amazing. They are fantastic. I hope you like my version. I hope you like the whole editing process and this video. Thank you very much for watching. Please consider subscribing if you are not already, and see you in the next video. Bye.